In different corners of Rachel Carter's Charlotte, Vermont house and her life in it, it's easy to find traces of the music band Phish.
These are all clippings from Coventry.
Her furniture is adorned with Phish concert pictures.
It's our Phish table.
Her cats are named after Phish songs.
Mrs. Fee.
Even her public relations business was built based on life lessons she learned at Phish concerts.
I learned a lot about myself going to Phish shows, so I kind of integrated that all together.
So it goes without saying, she was heartbroken when the Vermont-grown jam band broke up 4.5 years ago.
It was hard. It was definitely kind of getting over a relationship.
Then, just as she was getting off the emotional roller coaster, news this past fall that the foursome was getting back together.
So that was difficult, saying, well, I had gotten you out of my life and now you're back again. What am I going to do? But I've gotten over that and I'm ready.
Ready is quite the understatement for Phish fans.
Oh, I was so excited.
I think a lot of people have been waiting for this for quite some time.
Many of whom have gone to more shows than they can count on all their fingers and toes.
I've been to like 50, 60 plus.
They can add to that 3 more this March in Virginia and announced Thursday 10 on top of that in June at various venues.
Yeah, I'm actually going to go to all of them.
If all the money in the world could get us there, yeah, we'll be going.
Looking at the list, though, there are no events scheduled for Vermont, their home state, where they played their farewell concert in 2004, which is a little disappointing for some fans.
I wish they would play up here on their tour.
But while some may not like it, they understand it.
And they've got to do what they got to do.
It would take a lot more than that to get die-hard Phish fans to hold a grudge.
There's just some music that's like, just gets you to jump out of your skin.
Some people have like NASCAR or book club or wine club, and you know, we have Phish.
Which they can now quite happily say in the present tense. In Charlotte, Anya Hunneke, News Channel 5.